are going to invite the next speaker. This gentleman is an internationally renowned strategist, economist, consultant, and a CEO executive coach who has worked for government of Dubai and Abu Dhabi for more than 15 years and working in 18 different countries representing Dubai and Abu Dhabi in economic modeling, strategic planning, and conducting executive coaching. And he's also a highly reputed senior government advisor for Dubai and Abu Dhabi with massive hands-on proven experience. So, ladies and gentlemen, please invite Dr. Udaya Indrarathna to the podium.
Thank you, everyone, academics, ministers, and all distinguished guests. And thank you very much for the invitation. There are a few people that I wish to thank. I came to Sri Lanka after 36 years studying and working. So there have been few people that I must mention here who brought me to Sri Lanka. The first person that who insists I come to Sri Lanka is my best friend, current commander of Sri Lankan Army, General Shavendra Silva, who insisted me coming to Sri Lanka. He's my friend from my New York days. The second person I must mention is Sophologic Group Chairman Ashok Patirage, who was lobbying me to come to Sri Lanka last 7-8 years, and he's been an amazing strength. Once I came to Sri Lanka, I met some giants, and one of the very first person that caught my eye is none other than General Udaya Indrarathna. But I must thank today Professor Sudhantha Lienage, my childhood friend, and we studied together, and his lady wife, Janitha Lienage, for inviting me here. We were talking about knowledge leadership, and that was the theme. I want to discuss what is the knowledge leadership means. We learn there are at least 5 levels of economic maturation as a leadership. The very first level we call agrarian, which means the leadership maturity level is to feed its people. Second is natural resources maturity, which they are able to get oil or mineral from the ground and manage the economy. Sorry. The third level is manufacturing, which is manufacturing or assembly capability hub. The fourth is a service economy maturity and to make service hub. The last we call unity leadership is called a knowledge economy and global competitive leadership. So what happens is, if you look at any leader, if they come here only, they know all that. So we definitely need that level of leader, and I very much say Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa is a very much knowledge economy leader that we have in hand, and we are so happy to have him as our next president.